Okay, I will show you guys how to calculate this limit, the limit as x approaching 4 of inverse tangent of 1 over x minus 4. First of all, this right here is just the inverse tangent notation, and of course, sometimes you can write it as arc, the arc tangent. Both of them mean the same thing. Anyway, suppose we're just plugging this 4 into this x. What do we get? We will have 1 over 4 minus 4, which is 0. 1 over 0, that's the non-zero over 0 situation. We can somehow draw a conclusion, right? Because we can expect to have either past infinity or negative infinity. But we don't know which one's which. And in this case, the question is asking us, limit as x approaching 4 without any plus nor minus right here. So the best way is, we're just going to break down into two pieces, make sure that we have the same answer from the positive direction and also the negative direction. So we must check both. Let's go ahead and perhaps I'll write this down. We are going to first check the limit as x approaching 4, that's to the positive first, of the inverse tangent of 1 over x minus 4. And remember, when we have 4 plus, you can just imagine you have a number that's slightly bigger than 4. So that's like 4.0001, and you plug into here. And this is how you can show where to kind of reason out your answer. Let me just plug in 4 plus right here. So we will have inverse tangent right here, and also 1 over 4 plus, and then minus 4, like that. And as you can see, once again, this is at 4.001 minus 4, you get 0.001. In another word, that's like 0 plus. So I'm going to write this down. This is like saying inverse tangent of 1 over 0 plus. And now we can reason out the answer. Because on the top, this is positive 1 over 0 plus, it's also positive. And once again, whenever we have a non-zero number over 0, we can expect to have either positive infinity or negative infinity, as long as you work out the sign. Because we see that both of them are positive. So when you divide, of course, it's positive. So I can reason out that this right here inside goes to positive infinity. And we still have to work out the inverse tangent though. But let me put down the positive infinity inside. And in the end, this is what we have to answer. What is the inverse tangent of infinity? Well, to do that, we have to know the graph of the inverse tangent, and let me just write it down right here. Inverse tangent, it has two horizontal isotopes. So let me just put this down right here. This one is at y equals to positive pi over 2. And then the other one is right here at negative pi over 2. And when you graph inverse tangent, it looks like this. Right, so this is the graph for inverse tangent of x. And as you can see, when you have inverse tangent of infinity, meaning you are looking for this horizontal isotope, and you get the y value is positive pi over 2. So that's the limit in this situation. All right, now we just have to do the other case. Let me put it down right here. We are going to figure out what's the limit as x approaching 4 minus of inverse tangent of 1 over x minus 4. And to do this, we will do the same thing. Let's go ahead plugging 4 minus into this x. So we get the inverse tangent of 1 over 4 minus minus 4. And now, what's 4 minus? You can imagine 4 minus is like 3.999, just a number that's slightly smaller than 4. Just a number that's slightly smaller than 4. And when you have that minus 4, this time we get 0 minus. So let me write it down. This is the inverse tangent. On the top, I still have positive 1. But on the bottom this time, we have the 0 minus. And you can just work this out again, like 3.999 minus 4. You get negative 0.001. So this 0 minus is negative. In this situation, when we have positive non-zero number over 0 minus, we end up with negative infinity. So that's exactly what we have right here. Just do the inverse tangent of negative infinity. And this is not like that one, because this time when you have negative infinity inside, inverse tangent goes to negative pi over 2. All right, so this right here will be the answer for this limit. And now, what is the answer to that? Remember, in order for this to exist, we must have this and that, namely the limit from the right and the limit from the left. They must agree with each other. But in this case, they don't agree, right? This is like saying when you have a boyfriend and a girlfriend, and because the boyfriend will always be late, and then the girlfriend will always be on time, a little bit earlier than like 4 o'clock or something. Imagine if the boyfriend goes to pi over 2 and the girlfriend goes to negative pi over 2. They are going to different directions. They are going to different places. That's no good. They are not going to be happy. So I will just put down DNE, right, does not exist. And that is it. But remember, if this was the question by itself, that would be the answer. And this would be the answer for that, if this was the question by itself. But altogether, sorry, does not exist.